Two of China's leaders in humanoid robotics are unleashing their potentially game-changing next-generation machines into the world. Hangzhou-based Unitree Robotics, whose humanoids are already becoming ubiquitous, is bringing the cost to entry to a new low, while Shanghai's Fourier is targeting the consumer market with something completely different. They're positioning their intelligent robots as Trojan horses for bringing physical AI into homes, schools, and workplaces at scale. It could be the beginning of a whole new era. Unitree Robotics just unveiled its most affordable and potentially disruptive AI-powered humanoid robot yet. The Chinese robotics leader, launched by Wang Xingxing back in 2016, recently achieved unicorn status. It's now heading toward an IPO on the Hong Kong Stock Exchange, where it will join fellow fake human makers Shenzhen Dobot and UbiTech. The Hangzhou-based startup broke into the mainstream in 2021 with its quadrupedal robots priced under $3,000, far cheaper than Western counterparts like Boston Dynamics' 75 grand robotic dog spot. Unitree ventured into humanoid robotics in 2023, shortly before the Chinese government made it a national policy to mass-produce humanoids by 2025 and lead the emerging market by 2027. Its flagship robotic humanoid, the full-sized H1, surprised observers with its acrobatic and running capabilities. But its entry price, around $90,000, placed it out of reach for most. Unitree's follow-up, the G1, changed the game, bringing the barrier to entry to an all-time low. The $16,000 price tag was considered shocking just a year ago, but it's since been undercut several times over by fellow Chinese upstarts like Engine AI, Noetics, and Agibot, as well as Western firms like Silicon Valley's K-Scale Labs. Unitree is bringing its next generation bot to market as its humanoids become increasingly common outside China, popping up on the streets of San Francisco, Detroit, and Austin.
I had a really interesting encounter today with a robot, and I want to talk about it.
What up? Name's Jake, but in the streets they call me Rizbot.
Price starting under $6,000, Unitree's R1 humanoid is 60% cheaper than the G1. Standing 127 centimeters or 4 feet 2 inches, the newcomer is about the same height as Unitree's original short king. However, it's also 10 kilograms lighter, weighing just 25 kilos or 55 pounds. So it's about the same height and weight as a typical 7-year-old child. According to Unitree, the R1 uses a multimodal large language model to understand what people say and what it sees. A binocular camera system provides ultra-wide angle visual perception, while a 4-mic array helps the robot hear sounds and voices from different directions. It talks and plays audio through dual speakers. The R1 humanoid boasts a reported 26 degrees of freedom across its body, which is 3 more than the G1's base model, which has 23. However, high-end versions of the G1, like the ones used in Unitree's marketing videos, go up to 43 degrees of freedom. The newer robots have 6 joints in each leg and 5 in each arm for dynamic walking and advanced moves like cartwheels and handstands. Unitree says the robots run on smart, swappable batteries that last up to 7 hours per charge. They can also use external power sources for longer sessions. For computing and control, the R1 runs on an 8-core processor with GPU support. The R1 can be controlled with a remote control and voice commands. The educational variant includes an optional NVIDIA Jetson Orin module for more powerful AI performance. That version also supports programmatic control via Python, ROS, and custom APIs. The higher-end robot, whose pricing is not disclosed on Unitree's website, also includes optional dexterous hands. The aesthetics of both versions are fully customizable. On social media, experts were impressed with the robot's capabilities for the price, but one industry leader questioned the greater implications. Jim Fan, NVIDIA's director of robotics, said that robots doing parkour and flips may look impressive, but they often lack true awareness of their surroundings. He called it a mini Maravich's paradox, which is when things that are hard for humans, like math, are easy for computers. In the physical form, this means robots are much better at flashy, athletic moves that humans typically can't do. Yet they struggle with simple chores that bore humans, like folding laundry and setting tables. Unitree's founder would likely agree based on his past comments about general-purpose robotics. He's emphasized that a mature and unified end-to-end AI system is needed to truly bring robotics into homes and workplaces at scale. According to the founder, whoever solves that bottleneck could dominate both the robotics and the AI markets. Another perceived leader in China's humanoid robotics scene, Fourier, is taking its GR series of humanoid robots in a radically different direction. The Shanghai-based company launched its first humanoid robot, the GR-1, in 2023. The second-generation model emerged in late 2024, boasting 53 degrees of freedom, arms capable of lifting up to 3 kilos each, a redesigned interior for better agility and battery life, and tactile sensing hands for precise manipulation. Both revisions were marketed as general-purpose humanoids, though their aesthetics are clearly industrial. Fourier, founded in 2015, released a rendered teaser video showing a much cuter robot with a warm, cream-colored exterior, rounded body, and expressive eyes. The robotics firm says it will do a full reveal in early August. Initial reports suggest the GR-3 is much smaller than its predecessors, standing around 134 centimeters, or about 4'5". It's intended for use in homes, schools, hospitals, and public spaces. This video from Fourier shows the robot using its large language model for speech. It's Fourier's second short humanoid. The N1 robot, which stands 125 centimeters, serves as an open-source testbed for researchers and developers. Its pricing isn't officially listed, but it's substantially cheaper than Fourier's full-sized robots that reportedly cost more than $100,000. The available footage of the GR-3 hints that there's a desktop variant with a possible upgrade path to bipedal. It would align with Fourier's emphasis on modular design. Its short humanoid is explicitly described as modular, so researchers can swap parts, test joints, and customize it freely. Their GR robots share common actuator platforms and unified sensor stacks. Selling the GR-3's robotic bust for consumer-friendly prices as desktop companions could ease their robots into homes and workplaces. Fourier's new video also shows what looks like even smaller variants of the robots, perhaps as China's answer to Hugging Face's highly anticipated desktop AI companion. The strategy is similar to what Engineered Arts is doing as it races to commercialize and scale production of its desktop androids, especially its world-famous flagship, Ameca. Fourier founder Alex Gu has said he's aiming for mass-market accessibility, not just lab-grade hardware. He's also said that humanoids must be useful, affordable, and emotionally acceptable for widespread adoption. There's clearly a market for cute social companion robots. The highly influential AI company, Hugging Face, reported selling thousands of its affordable desktop humanoids it developed with Pollen Robotics, the startup it acquired earlier this year. It's among a slew of machines emerging designed to nudge autonomous humanoids into daily life. For more on the Ricci Mini and similar robots coming to market, check the related video.